Hello students, now see here A Bar Bar 3 part 3. They uploaded the question paper and answer sheet of science first. In left column you just see the question paper of science and technology part first, and at right side their answers. Now we are going to see the questions. The question first A is that solve the following questions. Okay, the first question is, for freely falling object we can write the Newton's second equation of motion as. The answer is S is equal to 1/2 gt square. Second question, molecular formula of the chloride of an element X is XCl. Which compound is a solid having high melting point? Write name of any element present in the same group as X. Now the answer will be lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, and francium. You can write any one of this given answer. Third question, when heat energy is absorbed by object delta T represents the rise in temperature. What would be delta T represents if the object loses heat energy? The answer is decrease in temperature. Now next question, which is the non-ionic compound in the compounds given below? AgNO3 plus NaCl gives AgCl plus NaNO3. The answer is H2O. The next question is, observe the following figure which bulb gate fuses. Bulb A 50 watt to 220 watt and bulb B 100 watt to 220 watt. The answer is bulb A. Now the next question, question first B, choose and write the correct option. First, H find out F1 and F2 of symmetric convex lens experimentally. Then which conclusion is true? The answer is F1 is equal to F2. Second question, if we gradually increase the angle of incidence of a ray of light passing through prism, then the answer is angle of deviation decreases, but after certain value of incident angle, deviation angle increases. Question third, which type of carbon-carbon bond are represent in vanaspati ghee? The answer is single. Next question, what is the type of the following reaction? The answer is double displacement. Next question, which of the following astronauts traveled through space shuttle Discovery first time? The answer is Sunita Williams. Question 2, solve any five first question is, Which of these element belongs to the period 3? Write their electronic configuration. The answer is S14 and P15. The electronic configuration of S14 is 284 and the configuration of P15 is 285. Second, if the speed of light is in a medium is 1.5 × 10⁸ meter per second, what is the absolute refraction index of the medium? Now see, for question given is V is equal to 1 × 5 × 10⁸ meter per second. C is equal to 3 × 10⁹ meter per second. Now N is equal to C upon P. Put the value of C and P. We get N is equal to 3 × 10⁸ upon 1.5 × 10⁸. Now 10⁸ and 10⁸ get cancelled, and 3 upon 1.5 gives 2. N is equal to 2. Absolute refractive index of the medium is 2. Now next question. Prove the following statement. If the angle of incidence of and angle of emergence of a light ray falling on a glass slab are I and E respectively, prove that I is equal to E. Here is the figure. And the answer is PQ parallel SR. NM is refracted ray. R is equal to I1. By the law of refraction, GNA is equal to sin I upon sin R. ANG is equal to sin I1 upon sin E. GNA is equal to 1 upon ANG. Sin I upon sin R is equal to sin E upon sin IE. Sin I is equal to sin E because but R is equal to I1. Now we get I is equal to E. The next question is, at which position will you keep an object in front of convex lens to get a real image? Smaller than the object, draw a figure. At the right side, there is a figure. Scientifically and technically correct diagram C, you have to download, you have to draw. You should draw like this. The object is AB and the image will give convex by using convex lens. The object, the image will be virtual and inverted, and the size of object is small. Okay, now question 5th. Complete the following flowchart. Polymer
rubber proteins DNA. Under rubber there is isoprene. Under isoprene there is latex of rubber tree. Protein, under protein there is alpha amino acid. Under alpha amino acid there is hair. DNA, under DNA is nucleotide and it is chromosomes of animal. Our next question is, why geostationary satellites not useful for studies of polar regions? The answer is, orbit of geostationary satellite is parallel to the equator. The time of revolution of for the Earth around itself, and that for geostationary satellite to revolve around the Earth being the same. These satellites are stationary with reference to the Earth. They can observe a specific portion of the Earth continuously. Therefore, geostationary satellites not useful for studies of polar regions. Next question is, write the proper name of the orbits of satellites shown in the following figure. A is low Earth orbits, height above the Earth's surface 180 km to 2000 km. B, medium Earth objects, height above the Earth's surface 2000 km to 35,780 km. C, high Earth orbits, height from the Earth's surface is greater than 35,780 km. Question 3. Solve any 5 of the following questions. First is, the radius of the planet A is half the radius of planet B. If the mass of A is ma, what must be the mass of B so that the value of g on B is half that of its value on A? The answer is, the radius of planet A is equal to Ra, radius of planet B is equal to Rb. Mass of planet A is equal to Ma, mass of planet B is equal to Mb. Ra is equal to Rb upon 2, half. Gb is equal to 1 half Ga. G is equal to Gm upon R square. Ga is equal to Gma upon R square A. Gb is equal to Gmb upon R square B. Now by putting the value GmB upon R square B is equal to 1 half GmA upon R square A. MB upon R square B is equal to 1 half in bracket GmA upon RB upon 2 bracket square. Now we get MB is equal to 2MA. Okay, next questions and answers we will be see in next video.